won't you come on in?
South of the border, hey, I know a lad. He's got more fun than anybody's had. Don't got no worry, don't got no dough. Everybody's wondering about Mexican Joe. Dancing, romancing, always on the go. Sun shining down on Mexican Joe.
One Sunday morning, I went to work as an announcer at KWKH in Shreveport. The engineer punched the button on the intercom and says, "Your tune, Mexican Joe's, on the hit parade in Billboard magazine." I said, "Oh, go away. I don't feel good this morning." He said, "No kidding. It's in there." And I thought, "Gee whiz, let me see that thing." And I went in the control room, and there it was. And I saw my name, and I thought, "Well, now, this got to be a misprint. You know, not me, surely."
Mexican Joe, dancing, romancing, always on the go. Sun shining down on Mexican Joe.
I saw this record, Mexican Joe, coming up the charts, and the record became just a real, real big hit. Now he has two or three offers from major record companies. And after he made the record deal and decided he was coming to Nashville, he came to town and I met him, and he was wearing a Western cowboy outfit. But when he got into Nashville, I said, "I think those things have got to go." And we went down to one of the downtown men's clothing stores, and I picked him out a sport coat and half-cut boots and not exactly a Western, but a gentleman's type shirt that I wanted him to wear. And I said, "You need to be a refined gentleman."
It isn't just black colored singers in Memphis and the Deep South that sing with soul. It's any singer that sings from within, from deep within. And Reeves once was purported to have said that the shortest distance between two points is a straight line. The shortest distance between two hearts is a song. And he realised the importance of that one-to-one, of getting the lyric and the tune through to the listener.
Welcome to my world. Won't you come on in?